Hello, welcome to another video. As you can tell from the title, the thumbnail, the time of month, yeah, the time of year. It is time for the mid-year book freakout tag. And you know what? I'm really happy with my time for doing it this year because it's the 4th of July when I'm filming this. It won't be when it goes up. But it's the 4th of July, so I finished my June reads, and I haven't yet finished any of my July reads. So every book that I have to pick from is like exactly half of the year's gone, you know? People do this in June, and I think like, but you could still read something else before it's actually midway through the year. Anyway, mid-year book freakout tag. Mid-year freakout book tag. I was right the first time, right? Mid-year book freakout tag. It's time to do that. I have all of the questions written down, but you know, this is just a good way to recap how we're doing so far this year. It's a tradition on BookTube, isn't it? Everyone does the mid-year book freakout tag, and I am no exception to that. So we are gonna get straight on into it. I don't know what happened to my voice there, but we're gonna get straight on into it. There are 13 questions, and question number one is, what is the best book you've read so far in 2021? Now, because I use Corpile, which is a rating system designed by G at BookGrost, C-A-W-P-I-L-E, I can go through my Corpile spreadsheet and see what is my highest rated book of the year. And honestly, I'm not surprised to find out that it's The Hero of Ages by Brandon Sanderson. This is the third book in the Mistborn trilogy, first era Mistborn, the third book of that. The final book of that, and for an ending, honestly, I swear to you, this is one of the best endings I've ever read, so it really didn't surprise me that this came out so high. Brandy Sandy is a well-beloved author, so I'm pretty happy for this to come out as the best book I've read so far this year. If you're unfamiliar with Mistborn, it is set in a world where allomancy is a thing, where they ingest metals and get the power that that metal gives them. So if you can ingest one metal and gain its power, you're an allomancer. If you can ingest all of them, you are a Mistborn. And the first book follows a crew of allomancers trying to overtake the Lord Ruler, and then the sequel goes on from there and so on until we have the final one, Hero of Ages. So throughout the series, we're also trying to find out who the Hero of Ages is, and the ending is just the best thing, the best ending I think I've ever read to a trilogy. I know the series continues, but the ending was just something really special and very impactful. So yeah, best book this year, absolutely, 5 stars. So glad I read this trilogy and wrapped it up this year. Question number two, the best sequel you've read this year. It could very well have been another Mistborn one, but I'm trying to like keep the answers very different in each one. But again, according to Corpile, going through my spreadsheet, going through all of the sequels on there, the highest rated sequel I have had this year has been The Ship of Destiny by Robin Hobb, excluding the Mistborn ones, that is. Which, again, doesn't surprise me because the Live Ship Traders trilogy has been my favourite Hobb that we've read so far. I think Mad Ship is my fate, is it? But I think Mad Ship was last year? I'm confused by time. But according to Corpile, this is my highest rated sequel, but with the Live Ship Traders trilogy being my favourite Hobb, doesn't surprise me in the slightest. This is the second trilogy of the Realm of the Elderling series from Robin Hobb, following ships that are alive. Ships are made from wizard wood, and after 3 generations of a family has died on its deck, the ship comes to life and is then animated and magical. But there is so much more to it than that, and it is not what it seems to be. There's a lot going on. There are dragons, there are sea serpents, there are magical ships, there are pirates, and we follow the Vestrit family. And there's lots of different perspectives, all from the different members of the Vestrit family, and where they're going and what they're doing and how it all ties together. And of course, this is the last one. It links quite a lot with the Farseer trilogy, and I'm now learning the Tawny Man trilogy as well. And I just love the way that all of Robin Hobb's series link together and come together. It's really cleverly done, but yeah, best sequel I've read this year goes to Ship of Destiny. Question number three is new release you haven't read yet but want to, and the first one that came to mind for this is Master Artificer by Justin Cole. This is the sequel to Master of Sorrows, which I read heavily on Ashley's recommendation. It's so big, it's so heavy, and absolutely loved. Ended up being a 5-star read for me. It had all the sort of like dark, magical, intriguing things that I love. It had all the right ingredients and was delivered fantastically. I loved Master of Sorrows, so I am really eager to get to Master Artificer, but holy hell, it's massive. I've just found out bigger than Priory, because I was talking to my patrons about it and someone asked. It's bigger than Priory, but I'm really excited to read this. It is a chunker. And what I'm learning from my mid-year freakout tag so far is that 2021's the year that I get into massive books, apparently. But yeah, this series follows a young boy who is raised by like the village priest, but there is, how do I even describe this? There's an evil god, and anyone who shows signs of being like influenced by this god is killed. So there's some signs that are being hidden and some evil god influence that's being hidden, but it takes place majorly at school, where they train to be like protectors of this village, basically. I'm doing a really bad job of explaining this. If I just had the blurb to hand, that would be better. But there's like magical items, and they are protecting this village and protecting the people by claiming the magical items and like keeping them away from people that could use them. Like, they don't trust magic users, but our main character is kind of split down the middle because he is raised by this priest-like character who has these magical abilities, and he knows they're not evil, but he goes to this academy where he's training to believe that it's evil, and he's kind of split down the middle, so it's kind of morally grey. But I hear that the series just descends into him being evil, and this is the sequel to that. I'm looking forward to it getting dark, because I think it's going to get dark, and I've now been informed that it's going to be a 10 book series, and this is only book 2, so I'm even more excited, but this is really heavy, so I'm going to put it down now. Question number 4, most anticipated release for the second half of the year, and it has to go to Sebastian de Castell's new book, which is either Our Lady of Blades or Play of Shadows. Let me see. Play of Shadows by Sebastian de Castell. I have just googled the release date for it, and it tells me the 29th of June. That didn't happen. It's not been released. It's really just started raining quite heavily. Okay. So yeah, that release date didn't happen, so I don't know when it's being released exactly. What does Amazon say? It's book 1 in the Duelist series, by the way. Oh, Amazon says 10th of March 2022. So it might not even be this year anymore. It was supposed to be this year, so I'm still counting it. But the Duelist book, book 1 in the Duelist, which is supposed to be Play of Shadows. Who knows what's going on with this? I'm just excited for it. So yeah, that. I don't even know what it's about, a jeweler. It's like companion to the Greatcoats, set in the same world, but following different characters. And it's Sebastian de Castell, who is my fave. So very excited about that, whenever it comes. If it's 2022, I'm gonna be really sad. Question number 5, what's the biggest disappointment of the year so far? And this has very little competition. I'm really sorry to Pages & Co, Tilly and the Book Wanderers by Anna James. This is a beloved middle grade about Tilly, who can travel through the pages of books, bring her favourite characters out of books. It seems like it's such a great recipe for a really heartwarming middle grade, and I just didn't like it. I think it got 2 stars from me in the end. I was not invested or interested in this story at all, and I'm not gonna dwell on it, but I'm really sad about it. I may yet continue the series to see if it gets better, because I feel like this had a lot of like introduction, and like a lot of the book was introduction, which could be why I wasn't really interested. And perhaps the sequels will build on that or move away from that, and we'll get a bit more plot, I don't know. But yeah, this one was not for me, sadly. Question number 6 is biggest surprise of the year so far, and for me I think that has to be The Wicker King by Kay Ankrum. I read this for the Read It Like Cody vlog that I did, and this is definitely not a book that I would have picked up by myself without that like guidance from Cody's list. Yet it's one that I've heard a lot of people really love, and now I'm amongst those people that really love it. This was a 5-star read for me, and not one that I saw coming, not one that I would have picked up by myself, so I'm honestly surprised that this was such a great read and a 5-star read for me. This follows these two boys, and one of them is having these hallucinations, and progressively they get worse, and as the hallucinations get worse, the pages get darker. And for the majority of this book, as a reader, you have no idea what is going on. This is one of those classic, like, what the fuck sort of books. But yeah, August and Jack have never lived in the same world, because one of them is hallucinating an entirely different world. But it's very mind-fuckerying, but thoroughly enjoyable, really fast read, very intriguing, completely captured my attention. And then within the last, like, 20 to 30 pages, it clicks and makes sense what's going on, and it's just mind-blowing. So definitely surprised me that I enjoyed this one so much. Question number 7 is a new favourite author, debut or new to you, and I'm going for one that's new to me, or actually I'm going for two that's new to me, which is M.G. Leonard and Sam Sedgman for the Adventures on Train series. I had not read anything from either of these authors before, but I've now read all of these to date. I'm really excited for the next one, actually, Danger at Dead Man's Pass. Maybe that's an anticipated release as well. But this is an adventurous middle grade about a young boy who goes on adventures on trains with his uncle, and every adventure they've been on so far, there has been a crime. We've had a thief on the Highland Falcon, there was a kidnap on the California Comet, and there was a murder on the Safari Star. And it's just told in such a fun way, and the illustrations, yeah, illustrations throughout it just add so much to it. It's just fun. Really, really fun. There we go. And each book has had this sort of illustration where it's like all of the characters, all of the suspects for the crimes. But it's just told in such a fun way. I've had a blast reading these. And although it's not like magical or fantastical, it's not contemporary either, because it's still this like adventurous journey. But I've just really been enjoying these, loving how our little mystery solver, and it's just been so fun. And I had no idea I was gonna love Adventures on Trains so much, but this author duo, I think anything else that they come out with, I'm gonna read. In fact, I have picked up something else from M.G. Leonard. I picked up the new release Twitch. Haven't read it yet, but I'm excited to see what M.G. Leonard does on their own. But this duo has become a new favourite, so that one. Question number 8, newest fictional crush. I really had to think about this because I haven't been crushing on any fictional characters. But if I really had to think about it and narrow it down to someone who I've newly discovered, because naturally I would have gone with like Aduin from Truth Witch, Wind Witch, Blood Witch or something, but that's not a new read this year for me. It would probably be Hilo from Jade City, which is kind of messed up, but it probably would be. I'm just really intrigued by his character. I don't know if it's like crush material at all, but definitely a character I've become very intrigued in. His nature is questionable, and I look forward to reading more about him and the route that he goes down after the events of this book. But yeah, maybe crush material, but just really intrigued material. Like, I want to know more about his life and his thoughts and what he does next, because yeah. But this series is about a city where jade is a magical substance that enhances someone's natural strength. It's almost like a drug. And this is pitched as like a Hong Kong gangster film. And you've got these two clans that are kind of fighting for territory in this city, showing off their jade and fighting with their jade. But there's this drug that's been released that allows jade to be accessible by anyone, whereas naturally it's only really useful to this particular group of people that are like, They call them like green bones. So these two families are made of green bones, and the jade is only really accessible to those green bones. But there's a drug that makes it accessible and useful to anyone, which could be a very dangerous thing. So it's Hong Kong gangster film controlling jade and this drug. Lots of murder, to be totally honest with you. But I really enjoyed this, and I'm looking forward to Jade War. But yeah, Hilo, I'm intrigued to see where his character goes. I enjoyed him a lot. Question number 9, newest favourite character. This was really difficult, but I've actually gone for an animal character, and that is Meffy from The Bone Shard Daughter by Andrea Stewart, who is a little otter-like character, who is the animal companion of Jovis, who is our kind of anti-hero in this. But I would die for Meffy. Meffy's adorable. I want Meffy. I would die for Meffy. So short and sweet there, Meffy from this book. So adorable. Love him. Question number 10, a book that made you cry. Fool's Errand by Robin Hobb. I know I said I was going to try and switch it up, but I can't. Robin Hobb is pain. This book was a pain party. To be honest with you, Golden Fool has also made me cry multiple times and I'm only 100 pages into it. But yeah, Fool's Errand by Robin Hobb. There is a heartbreaking moment in this one. This is the first book of the third trilogy, where we are back to the characters we were in the first trilogy. Many years have passed, but the story continues. But yeah, something really heartbreaking happens in this one and I cried. I think everyone doing the Elderling Along cried. We all cried. We cried on a live stream. We all just cried about this one. So yeah, made me cry. A book that made you happy, that has to be Lightfall. This is a graphic novel, but it's so beautiful. It is about a young girl whose grandfather kind of goes missing. He goes wandering and he's not like safe enough to go and do that on his own. So our main character has to journey to find him, and she meets Cad, who is a Galdurian, who is potentially the last of his kind, and they go on this journey together to try and find her pig wizard grandfather. But it's just such a beautiful book. The art style is gorgeous. It was just such a fantastic reading experience. I buddy read it with Steph as well, which was fantastic. But it's so cute. I mean, it's not necessarily like the happiest of stories. There's a lot of focus on our main character's anxieties about this journey and her self-doubt and things like that, but it just made me happy to read it. I had a good time and I'm really looking forward to the sequel to this one, if slash when that ever comes. But yeah, magical, beautiful, just heartwarming. I really enjoyed this one. Number 12, most beautiful book you've brought or received so far this year, and that has to be one that I got for my birthday, which is Honeycomb by Joanne M. Harris. Steph got me this one for my birthday. It is this light blue cloth bound with this gorgeous gold foiling, and it's got bees and honeycomb and flowers all over it. But yeah, this is just gorgeous. This is about a story that the bees used to tell. Long ago, far away and long ago, the world was honeycomb. We know the worlds were honeycomb. Yeah, there's a story the bees used to tell. And I think it follows like a bee, the lacewing king, journeying through the worlds in the honeycomb. But yeah, this is just a gorgeous book. So absolutely that one. And then finally, the last question, question 13, what books do you need to read by the end of the year? And there are many. I need to continue with the Robin Hobb. I need to read The Name of the Wind. It's happening this year. As we've established from this stack, I'm reading big books this year and this is gonna be one of them. In fact, I'm reading this in July. I haven't started it yet, but it's happening, folks. It's happening. 2021 is the year for Name of the Wind. But alongside that, of course, I need to continue with The Tawny Man and read more Hobb. And I need to get to Witch Shadow, which is another anticipated release, like new release anticipated read, but I'm doing the Witchlands Along, so I will get to that one fine. But yeah, really excited about this one. Second from last in the series, there will be one more, but this is Azeoth's book, and Azeoth's my favourite character from this series, so very excited about this. But honestly, there's so many I need to get to, so it's really hard to narrow it down to one. But there's a few. I think main priority is getting Name of the Wind done though, to be honest. And there we have it. There is the mid-year book freakout tag complete. I hope you have enjoyed. If you have, give us a thumbs up, chat to me down below. Let me know what you've thought of any of the books that I have read. Don't spoil any of those that I haven't yet. But yeah, that is it for this video. Thank you ever so much for hanging out with me for a bit, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.